staff today, and the, all the staff yesterday at the polling stations as well. I want to thank everyone that's helped me over the last couple of months with poster and leaflet and whatever else. My wife as well for having the patience with a wee 3-month-old baby at home, so it's been tough on her. I just want to thank obviously all the people that came out and showed their support for me. Bradley and I are obviously two new candidates, so it's great that they have come out and showed their support, and we obviously want to repay the faith that they've shown in us. I know Lisnasharragh has been, that previously all the councillors worked well together, and I also have a good relationship already with Brian and Séamus, and maybe get to know the two advanced fellows as well. But hopefully, yep, we can continue in that spirit of cooperation. So, thank you.
I just want to sort of echo what Davy said there. Thanks to the Deputy Returning Officer, to the election staff, to all the polling staff, and to the people who came out and voted for myself and for Davy and endorsed the Democratic Unionist Party at this election. Thanks to our East Belfast team, our MLAs, Joanne Bunting and David Brooks, and of course our MP Gavin Robinson. But most of all, thanks to our election agents, Johnny and Leanne. Leanne especially for the so many countless hours she's given up to support us and everything that we've done throughout this campaign. You know, without her, we probably wouldn't be standing here elected, so we're very grateful to her. And thanks to all those, I'm sure the other candidates would agree, that have given up their time for us as candidates. They have their lives, they have their jobs, and they sacrifice so much time to do posters, to do labels, to knock doors for all of us. I'm sure we're all very, very grateful to all of them for doing that. So thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks very much. I managed to go to the wrong places and haven't prepared a speech either, so it's going to be nothing hard. But yeah, I think the first people I want to think about, thank my running mates, Anna and Michael. We worked as a team throughout the entire thing, and every night come out together. It was hard work, but you know, it's paid off, and I'm really pleased with the result we've had. I'm just sorry that I didn't make it for the night this time, but I'm sure she will next. In terms then of others who come out to help us as well, I mean, these things in politics are such a team effort. So many people coming out, giving up their free time, knocking doors, delivering leaflets, whatever it may be. They really are the unsung heroes, and you just can't give them enough thanks for them, and you're the elected rep that benefits from their efforts. And finally, you know, in terms of managing the county today and all the rest, we really appreciate all the work that's been done. It's not easy to go through all those papers and the various missed votes and mistakes that people make. And we really thank them for all their efforts to get it right and make sure that we get the right result. So thank you very much. And
look forward to 4 years of here.
I genuinely didn't think I would be here this evening, to be perfectly honest. And when our tallies came through, and tallies from the party started to come through and gave us an indication of what the result was, I didn't believe it, and I refused to believe it. And all of last night, Martin and Cleona and everybody else were all kind of telling me to try and have a wee bit more of a positive view of what I thought election day went, and it went in a completely different direction than I thought it did. I do want to very quickly pay tribute to one of our previous colleagues who stepped down from Lisnasharragh, and that's Tommy Sanford, who I got to know very well over 4 years as councillor. And though Tommy and I would have disagreed on many things, I did take a great delight in teasing him that if both Tommy and I had been councillors in Manchester or Liverpool, we probably both would have been in the Labour Party. So we have some shared values that seem us work very closely together, so I wish Tommy well in his retirement. It would be remiss of me not to wish my party colleague Brian Devon very well in retirement from Belfast City Council as well. I think our group room will be a lot quieter now without the disagreements that Brian and I might have on local politics at the very least. I also want to pay tribute to my friend Malachy O'Hara. it's very difficult to be LGBT in politics in any place in the world. I was privileged to be able to work with Malachy and with Anthony and with Mickey in this last council term to stand up for our community in this chamber, and I am sad to see Malachy go, and I wish him well for the future. This has been a very difficult election for me and for my team. I am enormously privileged to have their support, and I am grateful to the rest of my life for everything they've done for me in these last couple of weeks. Thank you.
Mal just wasn't our leader, he was my mate and I love him and I'm gutted for him. He's done so much for us over the last few years, but I know that's the way politics is. Oh, I'm delighted that there's still going to be a green voice in Lisnasharragh. This has been a privilege of my last 4 years, privilege of my life, I'd say my family the last 4 years. It's wonderful. It has enriched me and I think it's made me a better person. It's taught me a lot. Representing this city, because the city is a wonderful city. It's a head melt at times, it's frustrating, it boils me sometimes, but this city is worth fighting for. And as a Green, I know we're a small party, I know we're fighting for her, but there's still going to be a loud Green voice in this city council. We're not going away, we're going to dig in, and we're going to fight. Thank you very much. Love one another.